Kentucky and Louisville is one of the great rivalries in all of college athletics. And as big as these rivals are, there's no sport that takes a backseat to men's soccer. Tonight, the Cards visit the Wildcats here at the Bell. Hi, everybody. I'm Dave Baker alongside the former UK defender, Peyton Atkins. Peyton, this is a rivalry that is incredibly intense, very high-skilled play.
Yeah, rainy night here in Lexington for both sides. That's going to even the playing field even more between these two teams. The ground's going to be really wet, so be looking out for that.
All right, let's take a look at what these two teams are looking at. Louisville, one of 11 ACC teams competing in a six-game conference schedule. The top eight teams will play in the ACC tournament. No Conference USA play for Kentucky. They have a seven-game schedule, five home, two away. They play Duke twice, and both of these teams will play in the spring as well. The fall and spring schedules both count toward NCAA tournament consideration. Okay, for Louisville, they are coming off a season-opening 3-1 loss on Friday night to Wake Forest, but the lone bright spot, Pedro Fonseca.
Yeah, here you can see the lone goal that was scored by Louisville, a diving header from Fonseca. Great effort by him. Really made himself open there, and he's going to be a threat for the Louisville offense tonight.
And for the Wildcats of Kentucky, they opened up with a 4-2 victory over Duke. Amay Mabika, the Conference USA Player of the Year, was big in a lot of different ways in a balanced attack.
Four goals for Kentucky from four different goal scorers. They were all from four of their most experienced returners, so that's a very big confidence booster for Johan Zettergren. Be looking for all of their contributions tonight against Louisville.
The intensity and the level of play. At the Bell on the campus of the University of Kentucky, and we are set to go between Kentucky and Louisville in men's soccer. Of course, the Louisville Cardinals come in here with a record of 0-1. Last year, it was a top five matchup that Louisville won by a count of 3-0. They got out early, and you know what? It was just one of those nights. And so the Cardinals come in here. They've dealt with a lot in this preseason. They've dealt with injury and illness and all kinds of stuff. One thing that we should mention, outstanding freshman. I mean, everybody you talk to talks about Makumba Ba from Dakar, Senegal, who played down at Mount Verde Academy down in Florida. He is still hung up in terms of getting into this country with the proper paperwork and everything. And they're actually working with the embassy to try to make that happen as you take a look at the Cards. Coached by John Michael Hayden. He is a Louisville native who played his soccer at Trinity High School, then went to Indiana and helped the Hoosiers win a couple of national championships before coming back to Louisville and taking over this, his second season, as you see him there. And what a great job he did last year, taking the Cards to the NCAA tournament and now facing a lot of obstacles in year number two. The Wildcats, on the other hand, coached by Johan Zettergren in his ninth season. And you see the Wildcats in the home white with a blue piping, Louisville in the road red, and we are underway.
Like we mentioned before, wet conditions tonight, so expect these first couple minutes to be a little bit frantic for both teams while they get used to the field. Early on, Louisville giving the Kentucky back line a lot of space to play.
We expect this to be a physical game. It always is.
I
you can just see how many players are on the ball. Louisville has three defenders on Khalil El-Medkar early on in this first half.
And there's more contact, and we're going to see a lot of that. And as we're taking a look at rosters, we have not seen the Kentucky end yet. That's the Louisville keeper, Jake Galnovich. And Kentucky with a surprise in net tonight, as they have gone with Ryan Troutman, the redshirt sophomore, instead of the keeper of the year last year, Enrique Facuse.
Louisville with a lot of pressure when Kentucky's back line is facing their own goal, forces Jones to kick the ball out of bounds.
Cardinals look to center, but the Wildcats defense is there. Now they head the other way. Here's Evans. And the rain beginning to come down heavily again, as you can see it through the lights. It has rained pretty much all afternoon here in Lexington, and it was actually supposed to be stopped by about this time, but nothing doing so far. And Leon Jones poked that one past everybody.
Good pressure by Kentucky to force the turnover.
Wow, look at that rain coming down now.
And when these conditions are this wet, it's important for both teams to stay compact defensively, because the counterattack is going to be open.
There's Screen, who had such a big game the other night with two assists. And now Louisville will try to play it out of the mid, but Kamara not able to control. This will be the first goal kick for Galnovich. 57 degrees right now is the official temperature. And we'll see what the gauges say. They say the wind is blowing at 8 miles an hour, as the foul is called against Leon Jones on Kamara.
And set pieces are going to be extra dangerous tonight with the ball skidding. It's important defensively to get your body around the ball.
Haji Abdelkadir puts it in play. Now the Cards look to reset and re-attack from the back. Nicely played in the center by Kamara. Sample trying to duck it in. Nice centering pass. And boy, there's that wet ball right there. I mean, normally that's a ball that would have been put away.
And tonight's going to be a test for Troutman. He hasn't had a lot of game experience for the Wildcats. It's a big rivalry game tonight, and with these wet conditions, it's a big first start for him.
That was Emil Elveroth, who got his first career goal last year in that 3-0 win over Kentucky. There's a whistle and a foul. And this is really, Peyton, the kind of night where you just want to get a foot on. You know, normally you want to take good shots or whatever. I've always kind of thought on a night like this, yeah, you want to get good opportunities, but on one you might not take on a dry night, you take it on a night like this because you never know what's going to happen, especially with Kentucky having a really inexperienced keeper in this situation.
Right. Shots low and on the ground are going to be difficult for both keepers. So be looking out for Kentucky, who has distance shooters as well with El Medcar, to be shooting from distance.
Marcel Meinzer is another guy when he's in there who'll launch from distance. And so far, the three in the back of the Louisville defense have been untested. Abdi Kadir back there as well, but he has tended to push his line more forward like he's doing now. Conti working against the aforementioned Meinzer. And this rain really coming down.
Louisville holding a lot of numbers up top. When their wingers get forward, they almost have five up there on Kentucky's back line.
Gil Novach with a big boot. That was a big left leg. What nice footwork right there by Abdi Kadir. And that's going to be a whistle. However, Fonseca is saying that Rouse was tripped by his own teammate, or actually fouled by his own teammate. So there's the step in. They play on there. And I think what Fonseca was saying was it was the Kentucky attacker on the ground that caused the contact, but nothing going for our referee.
And even set pieces this far out are going to be dangerous on both sides with the rain coming down this hard.
Set piece, and it's a nice delivery. And an offside against the Wildcats.
Kentucky forcing the Louisville keeper to kick long. A great win by Leon Jones. And a great touch by Kamara.
just crossing 11 minutes in this one on a rainy, rainy night in Lexington. As the Cats and the Cards go at it. Been extremely difficult for either team in the attack end to put together consecutive passes.
A great switch of attack by Louisville. That's going to be something on both sides that's going to shift the defense. They've been doing a great job staying compact.
Cats come out of there with it.
Now you see how open the weak side is.
Mabika bangs one from distance. And it proves to be too far for El Medgar.
Good win by Leon Jones.
Jones was injured early in that Duke game. We're told it was a tight quad, and you always wonder because he missed all of last season with that knee injury, but seems to be moving well on this difficult night.
Both teams trying to play short out of the back when they can.
El Medgar able to win, but just for a moment. And the near side referee calls that foul. Brandon Artis, our referee in the middle of the pitch. As Elveroth stands in front of screen, cross for the Cats. And a defender got a leg on it. El Medgar can't get a toe on it, and that was a nice play by Fonseca. And there's one of those shots you talked about from distance, and Gil Novac handled it easily.
And I like that decision by Grosso. Like we said, taking those chances from further out might pay off in this weather.
Thing about it is you never know how the ball is going to come off the foot on a night like this, how it's going to react to the grass, or how it's going to react to the glove of a keeper, and that's going to be a foul.
So look back, layoff by Bailey Rouse. The ball along the ground by Grosso. It had some pace on it, but fortunate for Louisville, it was right at the keeper.
Novac handled that easily. As the Wildcats get the kick off the penalty. Grosso being marked there by Kamara. Left-footed boot, and that was right on target. Boy, and what a nice header by the Wildcats and a nice save by Gil Novac.
Wildcats are going to be very dangerous on set pieces. They have a lot of good targets in the box. They have Mabika, Grosso, Rouse, three very tall, well-established players that are good out of the air.
That was well executed by the Cats and well defended by the Cards. And now Louisville tries to counter the other way. That's Aiden Nokas, 21, from over in Danville, Kentucky. That ball taken away by the Cats.
A lot of good one-touch passing on both ends, getting themselves out of dangerous areas around defenders.
Enzo Maurice was the Wildcat responsible for that. And the Cardinal is down on the far side of the field. Was there contact with one of the videographers over there? I couldn't tell. Holding that calf, and that is Nokas. There you see him grabbing that calf. And the Wildcats really trying to go direct here. Louisville able to turn the field. Rouse couldn't connect with Evans. As the rain continues to fall.
You see Louisville quick with numbers around the ball on defense.
I tell you what, I'm not saying anything improper's happened, but they're physical now, and they're going to make the referee, Brandon Artis, make a call. And you can see Kentucky doing the same thing, and that's Maurice who will get called for the foul. And as a player, do you like it? Like, again, as long as it's even, as long as it's consistent?
I think there's something to be said about that, especially for a rivalry game.
Sure. That ball gets through. Nice flick! And the offside flag goes up. And Ryan Troutman got out there and got a hand on it nonetheless. But a great opportunity for the Cards as Kamara broke free. But the ruling is he was offsides.
Offsides or not, that has to feel good for Ryan Troutman. That was his first action of the game, and he came out and made that kick save.
Nicely done. I've been impressed with Elveroth. There's a nice header from him, and his foot skills have been outstanding. Carlos Sanchez looking for the whistle there and didn't get it. And Elveroth had it poked away by Rouse.
Both teams pressing very well. If you're the player on the ball, you're going to have limited time before you have two and three defenders on you.
Fonseca went down but did not get a call. Number two, William Portman, a junior defender from Sheffield, England. In there now for Bradley Sample. Here's Portman. Medcar can't win it in the air. And the Cardinals quickly try to counter.
Good read by Rouse. Just that final pass for the Wildcats. A lot of good one-touch passing, trying to get themselves out of tight areas. It's just that final pass up to Bjorgolfsson to secure it while he's posting up on the Louisville defense.
Portman bangs it into the offensive end. And now Fonseca. Excellent win in the air by Jones. Because Elveroth had released, and that ball was headed right toward his foot. Nicely taken away by Kamara. And a back heel from Elveroth. All the way across to Fonseca. And a Wildcat defense is there.
Just one too many touches by Fonseca. It's a great decision to leave it for him at the back post by Louisville. Very dangerous opportunity.
Great centering pass. Elveroth is a guy that needs to be marked. Man, he has played well tonight. Little back heel flick set that up. And now the Cards switch the field again. Tremendous amount of energy exerted by the Wildcat defense. Portman through the legs of Screen. The Wildcats can't clear it.
And a great win by Meinzer.
Here comes Evans. Boy, every time a Wildcat has the ball in the attack area, really bracketed.
Yeah, Louisville doing a great job staying compact on defense. If you're Kentucky, you're going to have to release the ball earlier because you're going to have two and three people around you pretty quickly.
You can see Daniel Evans trying to grab some air as we have just gone past the midway point of a scoreless first half. Kentucky and Louisville. Dave Baker, Peyton Atkins, our entire ESPN 3 crew braving the elements tonight. Glad you've joined us. Jorgelson kicked it away. Abdi Kadir, and he's fouled from behind. And that was Maurice. Let's see if he is carded for that infraction. Haji Abdikadir, 5'11 junior from Louisville Collegiate, Abdikadir. There you see him taken down from behind.
This will be a very dangerous area for Louisville.
Eight, Jack Fasteen is on one side to take the kick. And that was Fonseca who hit it. And the rebound by Nokas sails harmlessly over the crossbar.
And both teams trying to force the keepers to play long in these positions. They want to be able to pick up that long ball and go for the counterattack.
Rain now has just about stopped. Now Mabika will try to set the Kentucky offense. Oh, keeper comes out. No call.
And these are the conditions when you want to try those things. Mabika went long, and Aitor Bjorgofsson put great pressure on the Louisville keeper and got that opportunity on goal.
Gail Novach came out. I don't know whether he thought he was interfered with. The Louisville defender was looking for a call, but it was not there. Everybody just kind of stopped, except for Aitor Bjorgofsson.
Here you see the ball by Mabika. I don't know if the ball took a weird hop or Bjorgofsson took a little touch around the keeper. Looks like it went through his legs. Bjorgofsson kept running and ultimately finished that in the back of the net.
Wow, I'm not sure what happened. I guess they thought they were offside.
I don't know. These are the nights, though, that you always want to chase down half chances, regardless of if you think it's going to work out. With slick field like this, anything can happen.
So at the 26:48 mark, the Wildcats take a 1-0 lead. Mabika gets the assist. And Aitor Bjorgofsson gets the goal. And there was no protest of the call from John Michael Hayden down on the UofL bench. Meinzer won it, but knocked it out of bounds. And then Sanchez turns around and does the same thing.
That's Aitor Bjorgofsson in the 27th minute for your first Wildcat goal.
And now Kentucky, after that goal, seems to be much more aggressive in the offensive end. There's another shot.
Kentucky looking to test Gail Novach now with these opportunities on goal. And a great win by Grosso. Kentucky has a lot of height in their back line, and so far that's been used to their advantage in these balls out of the air.
Fonseca controls in the mid. And that's a nice pass on the far side to Nokas. Substitutions for Kentucky. 19, Brandon McManus checks in. And for Louisville, number 20, Nico Diaz. 5'10 freshman from New Smyrna Beach, Florida, and the Florida Virtual School will be coming in shortly.
Just a touch too far ahead of Bjorgofsson. Had that stripped away. Dangerous ball over the top by Louisville.
Boy, and a nice center. And Troutman goes up and gets it.
Rouse with a lot of time to turn, unmarked in the midfield. Finding himself in half spaces in really good areas for the Wildcats and able to set play.
And the momentum has shifted severely. As Kentucky now has dominated in recent minutes in terms of pace of play, and they have kept the ball in the U of L end.
Good pressure by Meinzer to keep the ball in the back end for Louisville.
Just past 32 minutes, they try to go long to Nokas. Boy, what a nice turn of field there. Wildcat defender sprinting back and then delivering a perfect pass to midfield. Here's El Medcar.
And Grasso's been great on both sides of the ball, both offensively and defensively for the Wildcats tonight.
Not talked a lot about El Medcar tonight and Screen, who had such a big night. Here comes Jones from the back. El Medcar to the box. Boy, and there's contact right there. Is that Jones that was still coming from the back? So Leon Jones comes all the way from the back, collides with Gil Novach, and nothing doing. So Diaz checks in for Louisville. 16, Colin Ennis checks in for the Wildcats. And he'll replace Maurice.
Ball by El Medcar, and there's Leon Jones. And the six collides with the keeper. The ball goes out for a goal kick.
Temperature certainly feels a little better since that rain has stopped. Wind not blowing nearly as much. But hey, it's fall, right? Substitution. 15, Brock Lindau. Comes in to give a break to El Medcar.
Louisville very quick to restart, looking to switch the point of attack. Get Kentucky on their heels defensively.
Here's Ennis. Well, you just hear so much good communication between both teams. Meinzer looking for an opening. And Kamara is making it very difficult as he continues to pressure up top. Cards have only got one shot on goal tonight against a surprise starter, Ryan Troutman, in the net for Kentucky. Gil Novac coming out again.
Louisville with some time. Good defense by the Wildcats.
Wow. Bjorgelsson got away with a complete push off right there. That's an automatic call in the NBA, but not here tonight. And the Wildcats retain possession.
And a great touch by Lindau.
Innes trying to wind up in front, but a touch too many. And a nice defensive play on the far side. And Innes couldn't get the centering pass.
Louisville pulls it back. I would have liked to see them go forward. They had the numbers. They allowed Kentucky to get set on defense.
Bika just so solid right there. And now Meinzer looking for help. Nice feed again by Lindau. Screen on the far side. And Innes with a nice center. Excellent shape by the Wildcats. But good defense by the Cards. No goal to show for it, but I think that was Kentucky's best offensive set of the night.
I agree. And in these closing minutes of the half, it's important for Kentucky to be patient and create buildups like that. It gave Meinzer a clear look at goal. It was a great block by Louisville.
Screen goes down, but no call. Boy, and you have got to be physical and stand your ground. Nice defense there by Sanchez.
Good defensive pressure by Jones. Kentucky with some numbers on the attack.
Meinzer. Screen looking for somebody in the back post. Nice touch. Lindau as he gets it back and just was knocked off the ball enough.
And a great steal by Screen.
Nice step in. Let's her go on the far post. And a nice idea by Robert Screen. Screen able to create some space.
Here you go, he gets around his defender and that ball barely slides past that far post. A great look by Screen. I like the shot from distance.
Getting that 4-2 win over Duke. Screen with a couple of assists on set pieces and played a big role in that Wildcats opening win. You hear a conversation between Conti and Elveroth. Portman with a throw in. Rouse went down and he was fouled.
Kentucky likely to take their time here, closing in on 3 minutes to go.
Each team has committed 7 fouls here in the first half. Interesting in this match, we've not had a corner from either team. Boy, Lindau looks good tonight. Not quite sure what that was, but his feet are good. He seems confident. Playing with a lot of pace.
Great cover by Mabika. He's got some time now.
And there's a tangle. And Donqua able to draw the foul against Bjorgelsen.
Louisville trying to create something before the half.
Here comes Conti from the back. Portman goes down. And now Louisville will have a chance.
A lot of speed here. Screen just can't get his body in front of the ball.
Yeah, there was no denying what Robert Screen was trying to do right there, and it was easy for the officials to pick it up. So now Haji Abdikadir, what amounts to just about a corner, bangs it to the back post. And one of the Cards attackers went down in the box. I didn't see who that was. It may have been Fonseca. That is indeed who it was. Louisville gets the ball back as we're coming up on the final 30 seconds. And that's Abdikadir that goes down. Only 20 seconds left in a half, so Louisville has to hurry. Kentucky has to hurry and get set defensively. Blast through the middle. And that should take care of the final 10 seconds of this half. And it has been a good one. Not a lot of action for that man, Ryan Troutman, because Amay Mabika and company have had his back on the defensive end. Everything we thought it would be, spirited, physical, and well played. And as we go to the break here in Lexington, yeah, you better be ready to go in this one. And Kentucky, on that goal right there by Bjorgelsen, leads the Cards 1-0 at the break.
This is football. And in football, You are never alone. FIFA 21, win as one.
So I'm going to hold on promoting you this quarter. Cool?
Drop the taco. Get in the car.
Does this Sentra feel like a compromise to you?
Wait, what?
The handling is good, right? No compromise there.
Nope.
Watch this.
Breathe, breathe.
Rear automatic braking.
So if this Nissan Sentra isn't going to compromise, why should you?
You're right.
Atta girl.
The all-new Nissan Sentra with more standard safety features than any other car in its class.
Today, foodies everywhere are combining new ingredients with old favorites. That's why they're using Tony Sachery's famous Creole seasoning blends. They add big flavor to your favorite recipes, and that's worth sharing. Tony Sachery's makes everything taste great.
We made USAA insurance for veterans like Martin. When a hailstorm hit, he needed his insurance to get it done right away. USAA, what you're made of, we're made for.
How do I register to vote?
Can we vote by mail here?
You'll be safe, right?
Yes.
Go out and vote. It's so important. Woo! It's the most important thing you can do.
Give us the Fall Frenzy. It's a postseason we've never seen before.
Anything can happen.
Give us the Wild Card Series. Begins today on ESPN and ABC.
Georgia. The whole day through.
Always a great one when Kentucky and Louisville get together. The Wildcats lead the Cards 1-0 here at the break. More of our halftime activity comes up when we come right back. We are just about set to go here for period number two. Wendell and Vicki Bell Soccer Complex on the UK campus. Dave Baker and Peyton Atkins here with you. Cards out there ready to go. The referee's out there ready to go. But I have not seen the Wildcats come out of the locker room yet. Unless they're undercover. But I don't think they are. And now here they come. And I don't know who's in charge of that. Isn't there somebody always in charge of that, right?
Usually.
And because the bench area is covered down there, we have not physically seen Enrique Fucase. But Ryan Troutman, there you see him back there in net for the Wildcats again. And Mabika in front of him, and that'll give you a lot of confidence. So one can only surmise from this that Johan Zettergren was having an extended conversation in the locker room at halftime with his team. Of course, Johan Zettergren in his ninth season, 2012 was his first campaign. And there you see the results between these two teams since then. You see how balanced it is.
And a lot of close results the past couple of years, but the last 2 years, Both sides took a 3-0 win.
So we are underway. And I have still not seen the Kentucky coach emerge from the locker room. But the Wildcats again in the home white. Louisville in the road red. There's Johan Sedergren, who's popped out of the locker room.
Screen wide open on the left flank.
Wide open. And he's taken down from behind, and they say that's a good tackle. And that was Conti who came up with that defensive play. And now Louisville quickly the other way.
And a great recovery by Elmedkar. It was just Jones and Mabika in the back on that play.
Dongwa with some fast feet came in late in the first period. And he gets the start here in half number two for the Cards. Cards now trying to play it out of the back. Nice one touch. There's Donqua, who we talked about. And whistle, and Kamara is offside again.
It's a nice buildup by Louisville, though. He's able to receive the ball to feet up top and lay it off and get an opportunity out wide.
Here's Johan Sedergren, and what a job he's done. And Ryan Troutman puts it in play. Screen miscommunicates with Meinzer. And then Bjorgelsen is fouled.
And Kentucky with a lot of targets in the box. They'll bring Mabika up. They have Rouse, Grosso, a lot of height.
So Maries will take the set piece for the Wildcats with a left foot. And Mabika, the biggest target of them all. Bodies down as Mabika got caught up down there, I believe, with Elveroth. And Louisville tries to race the other way before resetting. Nice ball by Evans. And Maurice with a really nice touch, but credit the defense of Abdi Kadir.
The call on Meinzer, looks like he was trying to avoid the call.
Attempting to avoid the call. Fonseca. Boy, it's just in that final third that Louisville has not been able to put it together. And much of that credit, I think, has to go to the Kentucky defense.
Yeah, they're staying very compact. They have good cover. Able to double team it. Here's a dangerous opportunity in the box.
Oh, that ball is centered right in front. Fonseca with one touch. And he doesn't pull the trigger.
When you're that close in the 18, you just need to pull the trigger. He took too many touches and had four Kentucky defenders on him in no time.
And then Elveroth takes down Elmedkar. I'm sure that is a possession the Cards would like to have back.
Great move by Maurice. Just no one there for the Wildcats, but a good ball by Evans. Pulls it back into the center of the 18.
Now Louisville with some room. Fonseca tries to thread the needle. And Conti, number three, a big solid presence in the back. He's been their best defender tonight. Bergelson beating off the ball. This has not been a great sequence for either team as Meinzer tries to clear it. Boy, once again, look at Conti. Now he'll settle that thing down.
He's great at setting play for Louisville. He can play short to feet or long to distance to his front runners.
Obviously trying to play through Fonseca in the middle. And Elveroth, nice hustle and nice defense on the side. Bjorgelsson tackled from behind, and it gives the Cards a chance. Here's Nokas. And a Wildcat defense was there. Meinzer, I'm not sure if he got hit in the nose or.
Here you see one of the most dangerous areas we've seen Louisville get into. Great ball. He's heading for the right area, but fortunate for Kentucky, Mabika was right there to clear that out for a throw-in.
Meinzer was well back of the play. Didn't see what happened, but now the clock is running and we go again. And Evans is going to be whistled for the foul. As Lebel goes to the ground. Bryce Lebel. And now Abdikadir with the set piece kick, and it's a dandy. And Mabika got back there and was able to head it wide of the net. And if I am right, May did not get it the way he wanted to, but got enough of it. But this will be the first corner of the night for either team. Boy, once again, Kentucky's defense has been really, really good. Abdikadir takes it again. Nokas trying to control on the far side.
Great defense by the Wildcats. These are dangerous set pieces for Louisville.
And now, all of a sudden, a third corner kick for the Cards. It's Abdikadir who will take it again. Far side, right foot. It will swing away from the goal mouth. When he hit a good one, and there's a flick, and it got past Troutman. And it looked like Bryce LaBelle got it. LaBelle, a freshman defender from New Jersey.
And a great ball into the six. And a header near the far post by LaBelle. Sneaks past Troutman. And now we're all tied up here, and we'll see how this momentum changes for Louisville.
Boy, it just came through unmarked. It looked like Leon Jones got there late. Jones was looking around for help. And that's a big-time celebration and well-deserved by LaBelle, who gets his first goal of the season and evens this up at the 56-minute mark.
Good sequence by the Wildcats.
Oh, what a shot there. And that was Bjorgelsen.
And Grosso been all over the pitch tonight. Makes that overlapping run about around Evans and a great ball across the six. Bjorgelsen was right there.
You're exactly right, and that's my mistake. It is very difficult, or is it just because I'm old, to differentiate between Grosso and Bjorgelsen.
They do look similar from up here.
Right? And same with Meinzer, except he always has on the distinctive shoes, as Evans got one right at the top of the box and just blew it wide of the far post.
And Kentucky responding well to this goal. Had a lot of opportunities lately.
One touch. And boy, Evans just let it go. And fortunately for Gil Novak, it was just wide. Pace of play, quality of play has certainly picked up here in the last 10 minutes. There's Meinzer on the release. And Fonseca able to stop the Kentucky attack, and he gets it back.
Great defending by Evans. Unfortunate call there. It was great pressure on both sides of the ball.
And now it looks like Evans or somebody's going to get a yellow card. It's Bailey Rouse, who was chirping at the referee, Brandon Artis, over the call.
Here's a look back. It looks like they just got tripped up.
And then Rouse right there, you see him with the ball on his foot right there by the referee. And that's what got Rouse in the book. That ball taken back away by Nokas.
And it's Grosso again. Great defending.
And an excellent challenge, as you mentioned, by Grosso. Evans with a touch too many. Trying to get it to Kamara. And Screen was ready for it. foul there against Meinzer.
Kentucky with some numbers.
Elmed Carr tried to get it back inside to Bjorgelsen. And it was cut off nicely by the Cardinal defense.
Fonseca wide open in the middle of the pitch. Meinzer able to get back and cut it off.
Not only did he cut it off, but he was able to control the ball. Excellent play by Marcel Meinzer.
Grasso again on the overlap, just unable to connect.
Here's Evans, working against Fonseca. Meinzer again. Grasso takes a shot. And like you said, the rain has stopped, but this pitch is wet. Make somebody handle something. And Gelnovac does it without any problem.
And Conti with some room, not afraid to take space if he has it. Good pressure by the Wildcats.
Wow, Gelnovac just got that away with Meinzer barreling down on him. Evans, no one there. As we've gone north of 60 minutes. Nokas tries to center. That's a dangerous ball. And Meinzer finds Elmed Carr.
And this is where Elmed Carr's dangerous, but great defending by Conti, able to read that.
Boy, he read it well. That was a big-time defensive play right there, and he made it look easy. Maurice. Looking to set up that left foot. Nice punch. Wow, what a blast. Evans with a follow. Deflected in front. And is that your guy, Grasso, again?
That's Bjorgelsen.
Oh, my gosh, I can't keep these guys straight.
Bjorgelsen. In the right area again, and just a tap in for him. Took another deflection.
Second goal of the night for Aitor Bjorgelsen.
That's what these wet conditions can do. It took a couple deflections in the box and popped out right in front of Bjorgelsen, and he was able to just knock that in for the Wildcats. There's the shot from Evans, deflected off of Gelnovac.
Meinzer keeps it alive.
There you see off the heel of Conti, and Bjorgelsen able to just tap that in for the Wildcats.
I don't know whether Conti tried to back heel that or it just happened. And then I'm not. Did they think there was a handball or something? I mean.
Looks like that.
At least two Cardinals pointing that way. But Aitor Bjorgelsen. Gets his second of the season, second of the night. Daniel Evans gets the assist, 61-50. And the Cats go back out on top, 2-1.
Evans with a lot of room in front of him. Elmed Carr wide open on the weak side, and a great ball. A great defending by Portman.
And Bjorgelsen right there in the middle again. Here's Bjorgelsen, who wins it in the air. Diaz. That was a good idea, I thought, by Diaz.
Trautman hasn't really been tested much for the Wildcats tonight. I like the decision to shoot from deep.
And Trautman has remained solid back there all night. Don't know when he found out when he was going to make the start. But he has been more than up to the challenge. But still lots of time to go. And that's going to be a foul against Sanchez. As Maurice went down. Here's Grasso.
The Wildcats doing a good job picking up second balls. Even if Louisville wins that first initial ball of the air, somebody's there for seconds.
That was a nice play to keep this possession by Evans. Here's Grasso again, and they're going to call a foul against Diaz on Meinzer right there where Meinzer lay. So another set piece for the Wildcats. Screen and Maurice back there. Maurice the left footer, screen with the right. And it'll be screen. Nice flick off the head of Sanchez. Boy, what a pretty ball by Trautman. And that's going to be a card as the referee stops play. And you saw Bjorgelsen say how many.
That's why they call it a rivalry.
And that's Fonseca who comes in late after the ball was well gone. Brandon Artis right there to get it.
Trautman with some time. And a good step in by Jones. Kentucky looking to slow down the game.
Coming up on the 67th minute. Wildcats clinging to a 2-1 lead. That's dangerous. How about that? Diaz with a great job of controlling things.
Just one too many touches.
And then trying to control things, he backs into Mabika, and he's guilty of the foul.
There you see the header.
And there you see Ruiz with a push and not giving Mabika any room to come down.
And Louisville trying to play more direct.
And as they do that, more dangerous plays and more opportunities for the Wildcats to counter. But Diaz, who was just brought in, has had the ball on his foot a lot. Lots of room for Bjorgelsen in the center. And Kentucky wanted a handball, but Brandon Artis said it caught the shoulder of Conti, and I would agree with him.
I like the idea of the early switch to El Medcar. You just couldn't get it off.
And now here come the Cards. Fastine had it taken away. Now Louisville takes it right back. Lack of disorganization, or lack of organization on the part of both clubs right now in the center of the pitch.
Both teams letting the back line have time and space. They're able to set play.
Grosso able to get it for a minute. Here's Fastine trying to center. Mabika knocks it out of there. Fastine won it in the air, and Meinzer got the second ball.
And a great switch of play by Portman out here to Diaz. But Grosso gets himself in a great position and gets his body between Diaz and the ball, able to win the ball back for the Wildcats.
Great, great hustle by Luis Grosso. Jorgelson got it. Came down a little ginger on that right ankle. Conti looking for help.
Good pressure by Bjorgelsen. Evans able to pick it off.
And he's still free. He's got Bjorgelsen with him. And that is excellent defense back there by LaBelle, who got the Louisville goal.
Conti with room.
Sanchez has got some room. Now he's got more. That ball is centered. And that's not the best touch that Elveroth has gotten tonight. Got a piece of a Wildcat.
Diaz gets around Grosso and a great ball to the six. Shot just a little bit high, but Louisville's gonna get a corner here.
Must have gone off the leg of Leon Jones. And they'll do it all over. Haji Abdikadir will take it again.
And a great header by Meinzer.
They keep it in though. Here's Conti coming forward. Leave on the far side for Diaz. Rouse tries to clear and can't.
Good organization by the Kentucky back line to take space, forcing Kamara offsides.
Brock Lindau, Kalaninis waiting to come in for UK at the next dead ball. Mabika resets the offense as we approach the 75th minute. And the Wildcats with that one goal lead as we approach the final 15 minutes, more than content to do this and use some time.
And El Medcar and Evans have switched sides on the flanks here for the Wildcats. Trying to get El Medcar on the ball more.
Nicely done by Grosso. And there is El Medcar. Center. Oh. And Bjorgelsen was right there as he was looking for the hat trick.
And a great ball by El Medcar right to the head of Bjorgelsen. He's going to want that one back. Just flicks it on instead of redirecting it toward goal, but a great opportunity for the Wildcats.
Grosso to Lindau.
Kentucky with a corner.
Their first of the night. Five corners for Louisville. They've all come in one like burst. And this is the first for Kentucky. And it'll be Brock Lindau with a left foot swinging it in toward the goal mouth.
Kentucky with two goals off corner kicks against Duke. They're very dangerous.
Lindau goes way to the back post. Every time the Wildcats are putting the ball in play, they're in no hurry. Kamara has been quiet here in his second half. Abdikadir. And the Wildcats will put it in play as we approach the 79th minute.
And Troutman in no hurry.
There you see the series history. It has been a good one.
It looks like Meinzer might have taken a little hit.
He's always a guy that's kind of dinged. And we'll see if he walks it off or heads over to the Kentucky bench. Looks like, in fact, he will go out. That'll bring Daniel Evans back on. And then Eric Dungwa checking back in for Louisville as the clock now restarted at the 78-45 mark. Screen got it. And that's a nice play to keep control by Rouse, who drew the foul.
Wildcats going to take their time on these set pieces. Closing in on 10 minutes to go.
Bjorgelsson got it and couldn't control it. Second-year head coach John Michael Hayden urging his guys to get forward. Time now becoming critical as we hit the 80-minute mark. Nice touch. Wow, and no whistle there. And it was Grosso who just got in front of a U of L attacker. I believe that was Fonseca, and basically just screened him out. El Medcar. Boy, and there's Conti again. What a nice game he's had. Ahmed Carr got a foot on one. Bjorgelsen to Evans. Let's see if Screen lets one go.
Kentucky doing a good job switching the point of attack, really shifting Louisville's defense from side to side, opening up some spaces.
Boy, they're really trying to bang it to Bjorgelsen in the box. They see that matchup and they like it. Kamara working against Mabika. And the Wildcats win that 1v1 battle. Nice pressure by LaBelle to take it away from El Medcar. That's a nice centering pass. And nicely won by Sanchez.
Mabika getting himself in really good areas defensively, able to break up these attacks for Louisville.
Brandon McManus checking in for UK. Nokas checks back in for U of L. There you see the Cats home against Central Arkansas and then Mercer and UAB before finishing out the fall campaign at Duke. Second meeting in the fall against the Blue Devils. As Bjorgelsen comes out and the Cats get much more defensive up top with McManus. Trying to hold on to a one goal lead.
And a great switch of play by Louisville.
Screen got it with a back heel and then controlled it. That won't go down on the box score, but that was a really pretty play at a critical time. Now Screen has Evans. And instead he leaves it for Ennis. Evans, what a dive, follow! And is that gonna be a foul in the box?
Looks like it.
That's Haji Abdikadir. And that was Ennis, who is trying to follow up the play. You can see he's still hobbling. And there's going to be.
Great ball by Ahmed Carr through two defenders for Louisville and a shot by Evans. Pops out on the back post.
And Abdikadir thought he had it cleanly. But Brandon Artis says differently. And you see the response from Abdikadir. And so, since the ball is in his hand, I'm going to guess that Ame Mabika is going to take the PK.
This is a crucial moment for the Wildcats. This can give them a two-goal lead with 7 minutes to go.
So, Gil Novac set to try and defend the penalty kick from Ame Mabika. Calm, well done. Mabika didn't try to do too much. Just poked it where Gil Novac wasn't. And the Wildcats take a 3-1 lead.
Crucial moment for Mabika. Great penalty on the ground in the far right corner. Keeper guesses wrong. very composed, and that's exactly what you want from your captain if you're the Wildcats.
Mabiga, the only captain on the Wildcat team this year. And you know, this Louisville team has played well tonight. Kentucky here at home, not a big crowd, but on their home pitch. And with everything that Louisville has had to deal with in the preseason, if they can get everything back to normal before this fall schedule is over, and certainly by the spring, you've got to believe that they're going to be a factor again. And there's a foul on the far side. And Evans is going to be called for that one. And Elveroth, who's had a tough night, not happy about it. And the flag goes up. And offsides against the Cardinals. Medcar had it taken away nicely by LaBelle, who's really played his tail off tonight. That young man has played hard.
A great ball by Fonseca. LaBelle tries to shoot. It goes right to the hands of Troutman.
Right to him. And look at LaBelle. He's still going on all cylinders. Conti, as we're under 5 minutes to play.
Good pressure by McManus, forcing a turnover for Louisville, and Kentucky's going to take their time here.
Evans battling in the corner and is able to punch it out. Medcar keeps it in.
Good defending by the Wildcats.
Mabiga takes his time. Pace Cox, number 20, checks in. Replacing Khalil Medcar. Jones is back there as Kamara tried to chase down the second ball.
Great positioning by Jones. Kamara had a lot of speed. Was able to get himself in a good area.
Nice ball. from Lindau to Cox. And a good defensive play kept it from getting up to McManus. But what it does is it causes more time to tick off that clock, as you had Grosso is going to get a yellow card here. I don't think that's incorrect. It was not intentional, but, man, he managed to catch LaBelle in the face with a spike. Watch this. So LaBelle battling, and Grosso just caught him with the back foot. It looked like as he was trying to untangle himself. Abdikadir with a ball that goes across the end line, and it'll be a corner for the Cards. And Troutman handles it easily as we're under 2 minutes to play.
Louisville trying to go over the top. And a great tackle by Screen.
Coming up on the final minute, as the Wildcats look to go 2-0. And Louisville, a minute away from its second consecutive 3-1 loss to begin the season.
Evans with some room. Wildcats trying to get some numbers forward.
And that's a yellow card. And the official signaling to let the clock run in this 3-1 game. Boy, and Evans has not moved. Now he's up and trying to compose himself.
So back, he tries to cut back, and Portman
kind of played right through him, and that was an immediate yellow. So Screen will take this kick. And Evans back up and has it.
10, 9,
final
8,
10 seconds.
7,
the
6,
Wildcats get 17
5,
shots,
4,
7 on goal.
3,
they limit Louisville to just 9 shots. And in a series that seemingly goes back and forth each and every year, this renewal goes to the Wildcats.